The Northrop Grumman B-21 Raider is the United States' next-generation stealth bomber, the first new American bomber of the 21st century. Unveiled in 2022 amid much anticipation, the B-21 is a flying wing, low-observable aircraft designed to penetrate the most advanced air defenses and deliver precision strikes anywhere in the world. It will be dual-capable, able to carry both nuclear and conventional weapons, and is set to become the backbone of the US Air Force's bomber force alongside modernized B-52s, a key strategic asset to deter aggression and reassure allies. Today we explore the B-21's lineage, examine the program's development and current status, and assess its expected impact on US and allied air power and deterrence strategy. The B-21 Raider's roots trace back to a lineage of experimental flying wing aircraft that emerged on both sides of the Atlantic in the 1930s and 1940s. In Germany, the Horten brothers, Reimar and Walter, pioneered a series of radical tailless aircraft, culminating in the Horten Ho 229, the world's first jet-powered flying wing. Conceived during the latter years of the Second World War, the Ho 229 combined a sleek, minimal radar cross-section airframe with twin jet engines in the wings. Though only a few prototypes were built before the war ended, the design's stealthy silhouette and innovative aerodynamics marked it as decades ahead of its time. At the same time, aviation visionary Jack Northrop in the United States was independently pursuing the flying wing concept. His company developed the XB-35, later redesignated YB-35, a massive propeller-driven flying wing bomber, followed by the jet-powered YB-49, which featured 8 turbojets buried in a 172-foot wing, exactly the wingspan later seen on the B-2 Spirit. The YB-49 achieved test altitudes near 40,000 feet and demonstrated a range over 5,000 miles, with surprisingly low radar returns noted even then. However, both German and American flying wing projects were ultimately shelved. In the US, technical challenges, particularly in yaw stability and jet engine reliability, along with a shifting strategic focus toward the conventional Convair B-36, led to the cancellation of Northrop's designs by 1950. Yet the aerodynamic and stealth advantages of the flying wing remained a dormant but potent idea, one that would eventually be resurrected with the B-2 and now refined to maturity in the B-21. The flying wing concept was eventually vindicated with the development of the B-2 Spirit stealth bomber in the 1980s. Northrop, drawing on its earlier flying wing research, won the US Air Force's Advanced Technology Bomber contract to build a long-range stealth nuclear bomber. First flying in 1989, the B-2 Spirit realized Jack Northrop's vision with the aid of modern fly-by-wire controls and composite materials. A total of 21 B-2s were built, and it became the world's first operational stealth bomber, capable of delivering both nuclear gravity bombs and conventional munitions with minimal radar detection. The B-2's success in combat, from Kosovo in 1999 to recent Middle East strikes, proved the tactical value of stealthy flying wings, but its enormous cost, over $2 billion per jet, and maintenance complexity limited the fleet size and required specialized climate-controlled hangars for its delicate radar-absorbing skin. The B-21 Raider is essentially two technological generations beyond the B-2 in stealth, materials, and design philosophy. Visually, the B-21 appears as a somewhat smaller cousin of the Spirit, but it leverages 30-plus years of advances in computing, coatings, and systems engineering to achieve greater efficiency and lower cost. Notably, the Raider was designed from day one with maintainability in mind. It uses more durable, low-observable treatments and does not require specialized hangars and climate-controlled facilities that the B-2 needed. The B-21 emerged from the Air Force's long-range strike bomber program, initiated in the 2010s to replace the B-1 and B-2 with a more affordable, survivable platform. Northrop Grumman won the contract in October 2015, beating a Boeing Lockheed Martin team, and developed the aircraft under tight classification through the Air Force Rapid Capabilities Office. The B-21 was publicly unveiled in December 2022, revealing a smaller, sleeker flying wing than the B-2, with a shallow W-shaped trailing edge. Though specifications remain classified, it's believed to have a wingspan under 150 feet and a payload around 30,000 pounds. Designed for a two-person crew, the Raider also incorporates provisions for future unmanned operation and features an open systems architecture to support rapid integration of new sensors, software, and weapons. As a dual-capable platform, the B-21 will be certified to carry nuclear weapons as well as a broad array of conventional weapons. The Raider's two weapon bays will accommodate standoff munitions and direct attack ordnance, giving it flexible targeting options for both strategic deterrence and tactical strikes. Although detailed performance data is classified, the Air Force states the B-21 will have the range, access, and payload needed to hold any target around the globe at risk in a highly contested environment. In practice, this suggests a combat radius at least comparable to the B-2s, with full integration for aerial refueling to enable intercontinental missions. Stealth-wise, the Raider is significantly more advanced in low-observable technology than previous bombers in terms of radar cross-section reduction and materials. These enhancements, combined with electronic attack and sensor fusion capabilities, aim to make the B-21 extremely difficult for even state-of-the-art air defense networks to detect and engage. By mid-2023, at least six B-21s were in testing or assembly, with the first flight reportedly taking place in late 2023 from Palmdale to Edwards Air Force Base. Early flight data has closely matched predictions, validating the accuracy of its digital design. Structural and fatigue testing are also underway to ensure the bomber meets long-term service goals into the 2050s. The Raider entered low-rate initial production in 2024 with infrastructure, including training simulators and deployable hangars, already being established. Ellsworth Air Force Base in South Dakota will host the first operational squadron and training unit, followed by Whiteman and Dias. Initial operational capability is expected by 2026 or 2027. Until then, the B-1B and B-2 fleets will remain in service, before transitioning to a future bomber force built around the B-21 and upgraded B-52s. From the outset, the B-21 program was shaped by a strict cost cap, $550 million per aircraft in 2010 dollars, mandated as a key performance requirement. That target has reportedly remained on track, with officials in 2024 confirming the program is meeting affordability and schedule goals. The initial development contract, valued at $23.5 billion, covered five prototypes. Over 30 years, total costs are projected at around $203 billion for R&D, procurement, and support of at least 100 aircraft. However, senior Air Force leaders have acknowledged that 100 may be insufficient, with analyses suggesting a need for 145 or more. If production ramps to 15 per year, the full fleet could be fielded by the early 2030s, aligning with the retirement of the B-1 and B-2. The B-21 Raider is set to reshape America's long-range strike capability and reinforce strategic deterrence across the nuclear and conventional spectrum. As the future air leg of the US nuclear triad, it will replace the B-2 in delivering gravity bombs and cruise missiles, ensuring the ability to penetrate advanced air defenses and hold strategic targets at risk, even in the most heavily contested environments. This penetrability is central to US air power doctrine. By threatening hardened and mobile targets with precision, the Raider is intended to complicate enemy planning and discourage aggression. In conventional roles, the B-21 provides a global strike option with unmatched stealth, range, and flexibility. It can operate without forward bases or large support packages, an advantage in theaters like the Indo-Pacific. By doing so, it forces adversaries to invest in costly countermeasures that may still prove ineffective, restoring the US advantage against integrated air defense systems like Russia's S-500 or China's layered anti-access and area denial defense networks. For allies and partners, the Raider reinforces the credibility of US security guarantees. Though not offered for export, it's designed with interoperability and coalition integration in mind, including an open architecture to adapt to future allied systems. The B-21's presence will strengthen allied deterrence postures, especially in regions where peer competitors are expanding their reach. Strategically, the B-21 is touted as a generational leap in long-range strike capability. Its ability to conduct regular bomber task force deployments will support persistent presence and rapid crisis response. Paired with a standoff-capable B-52 fleet, the US aim to maintain a dual bomber force able to operate across the full spectrum of conflict scenarios. Yet this strategic promise is not without challenges. the B-21's effectiveness is heavily reliant on the continued viability of stealth technology, which faces future risks from emerging detection methods like quantum radar or advanced passive sensor networks. Additionally, in a saturation conflict, even stealth platforms will depend on secure basing and support infrastructure, both potential targets for long-range precision missiles. While the B-21 represents a leap in stealth and precision capabilities, its effectiveness in a protracted conflict may be challenged by adversaries employing massed conventional forces. In such scenarios, the sheer volume of less advanced but numerous systems could impose significant attrition, underscoring the importance of balancing technological superiority with adequate force structure to sustain operations over time. At the end of the day, the Raider does seem to mark both a technological and doctrinal milestone for the US. It inherits the legacy of the flying wing, but advances it with modern stealth, digital engineering, and sustainment-focused design. Its affordability and modularity set it apart from its predecessors, yet some concerns remain. The program's secrecy limits public oversight, and while it promises optionally manned operations, those capabilities have yet to be demonstrated. Critics also argue that large manned bombers may eventually face strategic obsolescence as autonomous systems and hypersonic weapons mature. Still, as it enters service, the B-21 is poised to extend US strategic reach deep into the 21st century, offering a flexible, survivable platform that denies adversaries sanctuary while reinforcing Allied confidence in the credibility of American air power. For a more detailed analysis of the B-21, see our essay on Substack, links in the description. Thanks for watching, and if you appreciate what we are doing, please subscribe and support us by checking out our merchandise shop.